And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
Sodes.
Yeah, Big J.
It's me, your boy Big J.
Yeah.
And I am double vaccinated.
Oh, two what shot up? J.
Two
oh.
shot J.
Double barrel Okerson. Come for him, virus, and find nothing but a shield.
Get some. Try to get those spikes in me.
I'm Daniel Antibodies.
Danny Ants.
Welcome to the Bonfire on Faction Talk, Sirius
Big
XM.
Big J Vaxerson.
Big J Vaxerson. Sirius XM 103. I'm actually Dan Soder, and that's actually Big J Okerson. And we are actually with our crew of DJ Lou, Jacob Patat, Christine Evans, and our step Lou, Brendan, while our real Black King, Black
Lou
Tiger,
John.
We'll get it. We'll learn to get it. By the time we're in studio, that thing will
Can
be.
Can I say something?
Yeah.
I got it.
I fucking up.
I think you're not getting it, and I think the rest of the crowd knows here that you aren't getting it, and you tried to take me down with you.
No, I didn't try to take you down with me.
I'll do it 10 out of 10 times.
10,
do it again.
All right, do
Black
it again.
John.
All right, you nailed it. You're pretty good.
You got to let it come to you. You know what I mean?
I guess I'm just not feeling it.
You got to let the game come to you.
Yeah.
You're going to the game. Hey, DJ Lou, you know what I was thinking before we started? You still have, first of all, can you turn your camera the other way so we can see you? And it's not like I'm looking at you on a vacation. Turn it the other way.
What does that mean?
Flip it.
Flip it sideways so you're not up and down. You're the only one with the weird letterbox format. What are you, Justice League? Am I right? Knuckle me, dude. Knuckle me.
You just got Snydered.
Do you know only audio so much that you can't figure out? It's a camera, it's your phone, right?
Yeah, but I can't. It's on a holder that only goes upright.
Oh,
what?
Oh, okay.
I've never even heard of a holder like that.
It grabs it like a hand would grab it, and it doesn't turn it. Oh wait, there it does, like that.
Yeah, now you gotta unlock your screen.
Fuck all this. Now what?
No, we're making.
And he's gone. And he's gone. And
scroll your thing.
We lost Lou. Just
pull that to an iPhone, right?
Yeah.
Pull down your screen from the top.
Yeah. Oh, I see what you're saying.
It says unlock
Flip
your
it.
Screen.
Okay, unlocked.
And then.
And let's see the reveal.
Come on.
A whole new.
Yeah. Still, for some reason, a letterbox.
How is that
but
possible?
All right. But you know what? It's better. It is better.
GD world, is that possible?
It is better.
Man.
But you know what? It's better. It is better.
GD world, is that possible?
It is better.
Man.
I see your asses there.
Do you think when we're back in studio, we're just going to do a bunch of face touching?
Oh, totally. Yeah, like a special needs camp. We're going to be touching face all over the place.
Just talking while I put my fingers on Lou.
I want to feel your mouth move.
I want to watch you talk.
I want to feel your jaw.
Can I feel your breath?
Can I feel your breath on my neck?
Just talk right into my face.
Yeah.
Talk right into my face.
That's right.
This is a good new tone since you guys are the troublemakers in your new building.
We are apparently the troublemakers. Two noise complaints already.
Man, you're the
dose.
You're the bad kids.
But here's the thing. We're watching TV. I can't help with it. My badass TV thumps. You're gonna tell me to dial back my surround sound system because you decide to have a baby in a fucking crowded building? Suck my dick.
I'm sorry, I've got cinema quality sound in here.
It's happening. You think I'm losing that thump? I paid for that fucking woof. Me and Christine came home with that sound bar, Dan, and no woof. And we put on one thing.
And they got
one
trouble.
Thing on television. No. I'm talking about our old apartment.
Oh yeah.
We put on one thing and we got the sound system. And I went, damn it. we thought we weren't going to want that woof, but I want that woof. And we went back immediately and bought the woof. And now they're telling me the woof is keeping your fucking baby awake? Why don't you tell your fucking queef baby to enjoy the thump? Yeah. Or learn how to sleep in New York, you twat. I mean, there's a goddamn, hey, open your door. If you open the window, there's motorcycles, boats, and fucking helicopters and airplanes. Listen, like, it's New York.
It's wild just what's coming from the outside of this building.
You're just a fucking sack of cute goo.
Yeah.
You're going to take down Jay and Christine watching the King of Monsters fight King Kong?
Yesterday, it was Saturday Night Live they called up while we were watching.
Well, you know, maybe they do have a point with that one.
The performance of sexually ambiguous St. Vincent, maybe.
Oh, they're like, this is too much. Sketch comedy shall not bleed through our walls.
It was weird. Kong Godzilla, listen, you know, I felt it. But again, I'm a good neighbor.
Because that,
I'm a good neighbor in that sense, though. Like, I keep my finger on the volume button the whole time. So,
but with the subwoofer, now that I'm thinking about it, it does make sense because every time Kong and Godzilla locked up, all the noises were just...
No, not on this wolf, dude. On this wolf, every time Godzilla took a step or a breath, it sounded like it was going through your solar plex. But I'm saying, deal with it, you fucking baby. I'm watching Kong versus Godzilla. You know, I'm out on a fucking 8-month-old schedule.
You know how terrified that child must have been thinking Kong and Godzilla were outside its windows? It's just a baby, and it's just...
Dude, I had a baby in New York apartments, and guess what? You deal with it, man.
Yeah. And that's why.
You gotta just deal.
Isabella doesn't flinch at all. I'll drop a book right next to her, and she won't even blink.
It means nothing to her. She's got no. You could do that thing where you punch and like stop right in front of her face, and she'll just keep chewing gum. Yeah, she just doesn't give a shit.
We're gonna go eat.
Yeah, she goes, hey, Uncle Dan.
Ah, looks like little grasshopper. Still does not flinch.
What's up, Uncle Dan? You're doing your crazy one-inch punches again?
Uncle Soder's doing that thing again where he acts like he's going to hit me, and then he does it. What, did you like Kong versus Godzilla?
I'm not going to lie.
Because I said it was fun, I was worried you were going to get mad.
No, I was enjoying it. It was fun. I even went, I was like, oh, man, Mechagodzilla. That's Mechagodzilla.
Yeah.
And I know this, my buddy John, who, by the way, just went on his fifth deployment. Everyone send your prayers to him. Fifth fucking deployment, dude.
Yeah.
I thought he was retired. But now he's back. But he was a huge Godzilla fan growing up. So I, just through association.
By proxy.
Yeah, had plenty of knowledge of Godzilla. An Ultraman, very like Japanese. Ever, but I was never into it personally.
Have you ever flexed weird Godzilla knowledge in a situation where no one saw it coming? I mean, you're like a guy where you go, actually, what's funny about that is Mothra didn't attack until Mechagodzilla had already...
I'm pretty sure it's when I said the words Mechagodzilla to Christine. I think that was my first ever flex with it. Yeah, it was Mechagodzilla. Like... And by the way, what was cool in the movie, the way they introduced that, he goes, it's a robo Godzilla. And then the kid goes, no, it's Mecha Godzilla. Yeah. And I was like, it was Mecha Godzilla, wasn't it?
It was cool, man. They did a lot of cool shit.
I fell asleep before Mecha Godzilla got working.
Oh.
At all. All I saw was a couple of.
Have you watched it since?
There was a couple of little dust ups I saw. Dust ups with them.
There's a whole fight scene coming up that you're going to see that the entire movie, all I kept thinking about any time Godzilla or Kong got near anybody, I was like, how many people are dying just in scenes where it's not even a fight, where it's just like Godzilla getting to the city?
But that was a superhero movie complaints, too.
Yeah.
It's like, so you're talking about a million people have died.
Yeah, they addressed that in fucking Superman versus Batman. Yeah, and Avengers. But it's like, man, the death count in Kong versus Godzilla in the final death scene in that little triple threat match. It's just, they wiped out over 200,000 people.
Yeah, and just no big deal. They're like, well, thank you. Yeah. I mean, even the thing, like, is anybody responsible for the damage Mechagodzilla himself does?
And it's weird to think, like, how did you lose your dad? And you're like, do you remember when Kong got tripped into that skyscraper? He killed my dad and his entire office. And you're like, Ling. What the fuck?
In memoriam, Ling Fong and the entire Fong family.
Fong Enterprises.
Who are having dinner on the 27th floor of that building.
Yeah, who was at a Sailor Moon dance festival and then got crushed. Did his hand go in? Or there's just a high-stakes business meeting going on where they're like, Americans want to bring over business that we must have. There's just a fucking giant ape hand coming in and slapping the 16th floor away forever. Just like, ah!
to the 70,000 children that were all in one violin class.
Yeah. Remember when Kong shook off that water and we thought it was cute? Well, his knuckles were crushing an entire nun
fleet. Oh, my God. So fuzzy. Yeah, remember when Godzilla flicked that dirt out from under his fingernail? Well, that was a boulder that crushed my entire building.
Yeah. Well, tell that to my father, who's now a quadriplegic, because he was crushed by some of that concrete.
Not to mention, if a town over from you gets blasted with the radiation breath,
oh my God,
you're getting cancer.
Yeah, dude, he goes, you know, everyone...
the splash zone, it has to be hundreds of miles.
They're like, dude, if you were living in 400 miles of that dust up,
Chernobyl, baby, your fucking baby's gonna be born bald, never grow hair.
Listen, ladies, we're cutting all your tits off because that fucking radiation blast is sending cancer.
Dude, Joe, lay it and fucking lop them bitties off preemptively. But I'm telling you, those things are going radio. Those things are going full powder.
Boys, check your grapes. Because they might be a little toxic right now.
Yeah. Boys, keep your eye on the marbles, because I'll tell you.
And get ready to have some children with some thick skulls.
You thought Zika was bad? Yeah. I live right near a Godzilla fight.
Dude, they're like, what's wrong with your son? And you go, I was in college when Mothra showed up and fought Godzilla. And you go, oh, yeah, that was when he premiered his radiation breath.
He goes, which fight were you there for? He goes, the Ghidra one. He goes, so there's all four things were shooting radio. Yeah, you're not going to escape that. That's a little something.
I see here there's a blank spot on your resume. You go, I was actually, I was an assistant vice president, and then Godzilla kicked away the building. And I had a brain injury for 2 years. So
I was a radio magnate until King Kong pulled my radio tower out and used it to just lightly distract Godzilla for one moment. My entire life's work, my family, shareholders, the whole nine, in one blink of an eye, because King Kong just needed something to grab because he started to trip a little bit. He was very strong.
I was a cameraman in one of the news helicopters, and I glow at night. So that's... Dude, that's what I kept thinking.
The radiation splash zone. I mean, it's got to be a mile. It's got to be miles wide, that spray.
Yeah, and also, not only the dead people that got crushed, but then just people that are not dead under buildings.
Which is rubble.
Yeah, because...
Rubble people?
Oh, like, whenever you see, like, Kong, there's a lot of, like, Kong pushing Godzilla into a building, and then Mecha Godzilla just cutting through everything with, like, a laser thing. And that has to go miles.
Yeah, get past the lack of reality of the Titans themselves. I will say, I had a hard time. Like, when they got Hollow Earth? When they got a... I liked that. I thought that was neat looking. What I gotta say is, where they lost me was... Listen, I know you got to put your main characters in precarious positions, the humans, I mean.
Yeah.
You got to put them in precarious spots so there could be excitement in them getting away from these spots. One of those precarious spots was they were on a ship that I believe was hugged during a fight by one of the monsters, flipped upside down completely, and then slowly but surely flipped back up right on its side. No one important hurt whatsoever. Not even hurt.
Wait, hold on. Are you talking about that scene where that scientist was flying like fucking Maverick in Top Gun? He's a scientist and he just gets this futuristic spacecraft and all of a sudden he's pulling moves.
Oh, yeah. No, I wasn't even saying that. I was saying when they were in the water, when they were actually bringing, like, when they were bringing Kong out, the thing they brought Kong out on into the water. At some point, that whole thing flipped. It did a complete flip underwater.
He flipped it backside like a pool toy.
Right. And then within that, nobody important hurt whatsoever.
At all.
I mean, probably almost everybody on the thing's dead anyway, from the action of flipping upside down.
If they really wanted to rock it, they should have just had a bunch of floating bodies when he flipped upside down.
We can answer this question. Solomon in L.A. wants to know, we don't take the call, but thank you for the question, Solomon. Wants to know the favorite monster movie of all time.
Are you talking about, like, the Kong and Godzilla, or are we talking...
I think just monster movie in general. Right? We're talking about the big beast monster movies. I liked Skull Island a lot.
Skull Island was awesome.
I thought that was cool. I hate the old ones because I can't get past the bad special effects. It doesn't even hold novelty to me.
I would say
Christy, bring up the original Godzilla. It's laughably stupid. It looks like... Dude, but, like sock puppet theater.
But bring up the first King Kong, too.
Same thing. Yeah. I can't do it.
That's the Godzilla vs. Kong I want to see. Just 230 stuntmen who are used to being in big suits just fucking brawl. It'd be like mascot fights.
Yes, it's exactly what it was like. And it looked so bad. And their articulation, their range of movement, mm-hmm. learned that word on the show.
Yeah.
Their range of movement was so limited and so stupid.
That's it. That's it, James. Now hit him with the right wing.
So that was funny. My friend John used to get these Japanese video games because he got like a, you can get like your Super Nintendo can get jailbroken to get these like Japanese games. And you get those ones with like, it's like Street Fighter games, but it's with like the Japanese, like Ultraman and Godzilla and stuff.
Okay.
Do you know how shitty of fighting characters they are? Those people, they all have like just blocky robot people. So it's not like they're doing cool like kicks and shit.
Yeah. This is the original Attack on Tokyo clip from Godzilla 1954, which is
pretty great for 54.
Yeah, what's also funny
about... What
are you holding
up against?
54 is they're basically going like, hey, Americans, remember when you nuked us? You might have given us a giant lizard that just fucking fucks up our giant...
You happy?
So, thanks. Hope you're all fucking... My grandpa was like, yeah, that's right. You know? Mess with America, you get a giant lizard 10 years later.
You saved the Jews, but was it worth it?
Yeah. Now all the Japanese have to deal with all these big moths. Is Mothra a moth? He's a moth, right? That's why he's Mothra. Mothra.
Was that a real question?
I don't know. I'm high.
Did you actually mean that question?
No, I totally
I love
did.
You so much, man.
I did mean that. Because I was... Yeah, I'm dumb.
Hey, oh idiot.
If there was a cartoon character named Mike Ceratops, would you be like, is he a Triceratops? You know, no, dude.
Sometimes it's
no, he's a brontosaurus. His name's just Mike Ceratops.
Sometimes you just skip over the simplest things. And then you look back and you're like, well, will you look at that?
Where's that big moth? Mothra, right? Mothra's a moth. You asked it so. You asked that so, coming, like, just lost confidence in yourself. Mothra. It's moth, right? That's why he's called Mothra.
Dude, my small talk's off. I gotta get that muscle back up.
Have you seen that giant alligator named Mothra?
Dude, my small talk game is all whittled down to next to nothing.
You're wonked out. My favorite monster movie, if you start counting like the Frankensteins and vampires and all that shit, it's always going to be Lost Boys. I still love it.
Mine's the original Halloween. Is that a monster movie?
Yeah.
See?
Yeah, he's supernatural.
What are we doing?
He's supernatural technically at this point.
Jason never too much stuff. Jason never got my rocks off.
Me either, except when he was a little boy. That's when I was afraid of him.
Yeah.
When he jumps out of the lake.
My favorite was Aliens.
Aliens?
I love that movie. Yeah.
Alien or Aliens?
Aliens.
The first movie I saw, I snuck into the theater, was Aliens. I was just too young to have seen Alien.
Yeah.
So I saw them in reverse. But
the second one's better anyway.
I loved Aliens. But I love them both. But man, that movie... I saw the commercial on TV, and then I snuck into the theater. It was packed. My favorite movie experience. I was just terrified.
Really?
What did you say you were going to see?
Terrified.
Do you remember what you said you were going to see?
I don't remember, but I snuck
Man,
into
that used to be a thing.
Christine, look up what movies were out the same time as Alien. Like, literally the same, like...
Aliens.
86.
I
want to also show
this
really quick.
Yeah, I can tell you what Blazing King Saddles Kong from 33. While you were still swimming around in your daddy's nutsack.
All right.
I can tell you what movie, if I see it, I'll remember it.
Yeah, that's, that
but
King
yeah,
Kong
that
was just...
That special meaning for me.
Also, King Kong, that was the other problem people were having. Again, real nerd issues, but they're like, King Kong's not the same size as Godzilla. King Kong's like 50 feet tall.
Yeah.
Versus
what's Godzilla?
Like, hundreds, I think, of feet tall.
I feel like they made Godzilla morbidly obese. I like the slimmer Godzilla. I don't
diabetes Godzilla.
He's not very agile.
I do. I agree with you. Also, they did make him look pretty mean.
The Matthew Broderick
Godzilla was the worst looking.
It was hilariously terrible.
Looking like an iguana.
What if he comes back all ketoed out and just super slim, super slim Godzilla?
Jacob Godzilla here. I heard the critiques.
Also, I've been watching my calorie count. I got my steps up, so I'll let you know I'm fighting.
I do think the Japanese actually had a problem with the newer Godzilla. They said Godzilla's fat. We don't get it.
Really?
Oh, they're not a fat culture.
They got him.
Why did you make him fat?
You American.
No, Christine, it's Aliens. It's the part two. But yes, that same thing. just for aliens.
It's also under Aliens 2, Get Off My Ship.
Aliens 2, Electric Boogaloo?
Yeah, we've got to save that. See, I grew up, I'm younger than you guys. Aliens 3, I think, is, which is the one with the...
The prison aliens, is Alien 3.
Aliens 3 is the Hunt for Curly, the Hunt for Curly's Gold.
I'm so angry with that movie.
But hold on, because which was the trailer with the alien head and then the small mouth coming out? Was that Aliens or Alien 3?
Oh, well, that was part 4, Citizens on Patrol, Operation Miami Beach.
Aliens 5.
Aliens 5, Operation Miami Beach.
Aliens 5, New Orleans Undercover.
Okay.
Here we go.
Here we go.
Maximum Overdrive.
Hang on, I gotta move the chat thing.
Wait,
hang on. Queve Line at Wembley Stadium. Okay. Flight of the Navigator.
I think it was Flight of the Navigator.
Dude,
but I got to see
Flight
more.
Of the Navigator. Holy
Let's see
shit.
Maximum Overdrive. Vamp. I can already tell that's Vamp coming up.
Yeah. The Parent Trap.
I had to see Vamp at
Two.
Home on tape. Vamp was pretty freaky, but awful. Nothing in Common. Very sad movie. Good movie.
What about Club Paradise with Johnny Depp?
Is that what that is?
No. No, that's Robin Williams, I thought.
Yeah, it is. It is Robin Williams.
God, I'm an idiot.
I think I did pay to see that. It might have been
your second movie ever?
Flight of the Navigator.
I don't mean to go back to this, but Godzilla, he's a god, right?
No.
Wrong.
He's not a god.
I was following the leader.
Oh, Christine, your computer's listening to you.
Wrong.
Looking at couches.
Robotech.
So weird. Let's see, what else could it have been? Man, these, I'll tell you what, it didn't take a whole heap of shit to get a movie into a movie theater back then.
I mean, look at Prince Under the Cherry Moon.
I can't believe that was in theaters. Keep going down, Christine. I want to see more. I mean, these were in theaters.
Yeah, but it's great. It's only like one a week.
And what is that?
Out of Bounds. Young?
The Great American Bash with Dusty Rhodes.
Wait, that was in theaters?
But, no, this isn't all theaters. This is just things coming
out. Oh, okay.
There's just movies that were out.
Because I'll watch NWA, The Great American Bash, and from 86. Probably got Flair Rhodes.
Butthole Surfers live in Detroit. Finally.
What?
Finally.
I didn't realize the Butthole Surfers have been around that long. 86? I thought they were just like a mid-90s band.
No. That guy's weird as shit and old.
They used him in the Clueless soundtrack, so there was like a little bit of a revamp in the 90s.
Jacob, did you like Kong versus Godzilla overall?
No. I didn't see the movie. I didn't.
Oh, you haven't watched it yet?
Oh, you haven't watched it yet? You watched it, Lou, no?
No.
Oh.
Really?
Are Jay and I the only two that got to watch the battle of...
Two colossal titans? I guess no one else cared?
You guys didn't care about the fate of the world?
That's chill, I guess.
I guess it's pretty cool to walk around and not worry about Hollow Earth.
I was worried. Dan said it was very fun. So, I mean, I'm going to watch the end of it ultimately. I just nodded off.
You're coming up on the most fun fight scene.
Yeah.
But
Mecha Godzilla.
Yeah, it's just weird that they always end these movies the same. They all end the same where they...
Does one of them open an eye?
Where they fuck up a city and then they, like, learn a lesson through fighting. But it's a, they have to, like, show...
Godzilla, not so bad after her.
Hey, Godzilla, you're a pretty cool guy. Or it's like King Kong is like, no, you know what? I guess I will stay over here. We'll just leave each other alone.
I like people.
People are all right. Certain people are all right. But this one is like Godzilla is just like, all right, and just fucks off into the ocean. And Kong's like, all right, I'll see you later, bro.
See, whatever. Are you done? If you're done, I'm done.
That's totally how they should have ended it. Like every fight I've ever been into.
You throw
out of breath going,
done?
Is that it?
You fucking done, dude? You learned your lesson?
Are you good?
Have you thoroughly learned your lesson?
What are they saying? He goes, I'm getting the reads right now. It's...
Yeah, it's Godzilla. He's doing the sign language. He goes,
Godzilla is saying, I'm good, bro. You good?
You good?
You good? You good?
Well, where say, did they go?
What's up? What's up, a pussy?
Fuck
what's
you.
Up, pussy?
Kong is saying, fuck you, bro. Bring it. Fuck you, bitch ass. Bring it.
Fuck you, bro. Fuck me? No. Fuck you, he says.
You have to score one of those fight scenes with just that. With us going, you all right, bro? It's like when we watch UFC and
what's
I was...
What's up?
Whenever we watch UFC, I always do the thing where I would say ow.
Yeah.
You know, when they hit him with a low kick, I go, ow.
Ah,
ow.
Bitch.
Fuck, ow. Yeah, where do that with King Kong versus Godzilla. What's up, Jacob?
I don't understand. Where's King Kong's pad? Like, where does he hang out?
Well, you'll learn that he actually lives in, he's from Hollow Middle Earth.
No, he's from Hollow Earth. Skull Island, I think, farted out of that.
Yeah, Skull Island's like the Dingleberry from Hollow Earth.
Hollow Earth's pretty cool looking. There's mountains in the sky and on the ground.
It's basically a Pink Floyd song.
Middle Earth's pretty trippy, man.
It's just fucking,
hello, is there anybody in there?
And then we'll put some upside down mountains, but they're really right side up.
There's no sky because they fell from the sky, but in nothing, and then but gravity then switched over, and then the girl from Stranger Things.
But then they got splooshed back, and then my dinner came, and I went to the door and got it, and I kind of forgot the rest.
They farted back out, yeah. And then Mechagodzilla, and then a thing.
It's
radiation poisoning.
Dude, if you could do an entire recap.
What if you were near the fight, though, and you were like something, you were a cancer patient, you go, fucking cured.
Yeah. Dude, honestly, I had like 8 weeks of chemotherapy in front of me. I had ringside seats for Kong vs. Godzilla, walked away without a trace of cancer in my body.
He goes, now so, they're telling me, full remish.
Full remish, dude. Honest, I'm taking the money I was going to spend.
Thank you, Titans.
Yeah, so I'm just saying, you know, sometimes the ball bounces your way.
He goes, dude, I don't know how I'm going to live. I can't afford this chemotherapy. I don't have insurance. I'm dead. He goes, you want to go hang out? You want to go watch Godzilla fight something?
Yeah.
He goes, I'll tell you what, it can't hurt.
Worst case scenario, you get crushed by an office building and your family sues the business. So I can't really see a downside to this. Yeah, Kong vs. Godzilla is a fun movie to watch, especially if you do the noises of, come here, bro.
It was fun. Eric Andre is a friend of both of ours. His new movie is so fucking funny.
It's great. It's fucking great. Bad Trip with Laurel and Tiffany Haddish. Both awesome.
It was so funny.
It's just like, it reminds me of the Jackass movies, where they just set it up so funny that you're watching a reaction. What was the one with Johnny Knoxville where he's the grandpa?
Bad Grandpa. Yeah, I was going to say, there's no way what you were just doing was comfortable for you.
It was, though.
I have to get new couches. That was insane. You were taking a knee. You're sitting on my couch, and you were taking a knee.
Right now, I feel like a baseball catcher.
Yeah, it's these the couches. These couches make me furious.
No, I want to sit next to Jay. I want to smell him.
No, we have to
He's vaccinated.
We have to be near each other. I am, dude. I'm fully vaxxed now. Look out, people. Where am I going? Kansas City and St. Louis. I'm coming the fucks, yo. I'm vaccinated.
Yeah, man.
Yo, I'm bringing the fucks to town.
And I'm glad he's vaccinated, so now I feel safer when we're dual watching Bad Babies OnlyFans.
I'm ready to dock with dudes, fucking make out with everybody. I'm vaxxed.
Bad Baby made $1 million on OnlyFans.
No, she made more than that.
Well, I mean $1 million in like
six hours.
Which is, dude, every one of those guys is like, I'm just in it today. Today is the first day I even found out about her and heard about her.
Is there only... No, I've right been now. Waiting for this.
What was the tweet that was brought up? Ray Sani, I believe.
Oh, where she was like, yeah, check everyone's search history for anyone that signed up for an OnlyFans like the day before.
Yeah, I mean, she turns 18.
That's the weird thing about... That's like that weird...
Put them on a list.
Yeah, that's like that weird thing about the Olsen twins, too. Remember when Mary-Kate and Ashley... I was in college, and everyone's like, they're 18! You're like,
all
like right.
It was like one of the first countdown clocks. Like, before, like, MySpace or anything, there was a countdown clock for the Olsens to turn 18.
Christine's talking that shit. Yeah, that was the homepage for MySpace.
She's like, refresh.
She goes, you want to listen to Sublime or maybe Countdowns of the Girls Turn 18?
And then once the clock strikes midnight, I can do a puppet show with both of them girls.
I mean, who knew they were going to end up looking like fucking lollipops with Google eyes?
Oh, my God.
They got crazy looking.
They look like if aliens didn't try to look human. They're like, yeah, it's quick. Let's just...
Should we take our first break and then come back talk Bad Baby?
Wait, guys, look at this bonfire Easter egg. Do you see that?
Of what appears to be a revenue, the video is set to Fat Joe and Remy Ma's all the way up. Really? I'm all the way up.
Nothing. How's that in reference to the show?
Oh, are you thinking about All I Do Is Win?
Yeah, you are.
Oh, I am. Never mind.
It's all right. I just learned Mothra was a moth.
Yeah, don't feel bad, Christine. You're fine. I don't think, even if you didn't know Mothra was a moth, you wouldn't have
asked it.
If it came to you in your head, you wouldn't have put it out there to the world. You would have just been like, I'm just going to act like now forever that I knew for sure it was a moth. Listen,
I'm learning how to be around people again.
You're growing.
I'm showing.
You're learning, you're growing, and you're showing.
I'm growing. And
let's take a break, and we'll come back. We'll talk Cash Me Outside. Brijol. Our old friend, the Brajol.
Old Daniel Brajol.
Old Brajol. We'll be right back, everybody. It's Monday. It's the bonfire.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder. Big Lizard.
I'm scared.
Big,
now I'm not.
Big Pockets.
Yeah. This is like when your little cousin, it's like when your little cousin at a barbecue is like, I wrote a song. And you're like, sing your song. It's like, I'm not afraid of the dark. You are not.
It is tall. Scary monster. I will fight it.
Cashmere.
Hey, there's only one person who can help us against this giant monster. Matthew Broderick.
Yeah. Hey, Ferris Bueller.
Bueller.
Yeah. What did Ferris Bueller go on to do? Defeat the king of monsters?
Yeah. They don't teach that in school, so I'm sorry he took a day off to kick it with his friend Cam.
Also, learn your science, because Godzilla drops a shit ton of eggs in MSG.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. He queefs out a nice batch. I had no idea Godzilla was a chick.
Yeah, dude. No one knew that. Walking around all Jamie Lee Curtis'd up. All hermaphrodite. Mighty hermaphrodite.
Mighty hermaphrodite.
Well, Bonfire Podcast is releasing new episodes Tuesday through Friday on all major platforms. So go tell your friends who don't have Sirius to download it, rate, and review, and subscribe.
And I don't know how often this will happen, but this week, wasn't one of them we have coming out is actually original content because we did too long on a pre-record.
Yeah, we're babbling.
That's correct.
We're cackling.
Can I tell you what's great about that news? What's really funny about that to me? As I swear to you, that day particularly when Dan came over before we started, and I wouldn't make this up because it doesn't make any sense. I would make it up, but this isn't made up. Dan came over, really saying like, "Hey, I should get actually a little more credit. I feel for how good I was at timing segments." Do you remember that when you got?
Holy shit!
You actually,
dude, I really did suck my dick. I sucked my own dick for it. And then what happened was Josh.
Oh, you left it in there.
Yeah, I left. It starts off by Dan saying, "I'm the timer guy."
Yeah,
you know, but I'm saying, but even before the show started,
turns out I was very wrong. No, I'm saying, Lou, I was in the elevator, like, dude, I fucking nailed those segments on the Lost Tapes last week.
Nailed it.
And what a swing and a miss. But you know what? One man's idiotic statement is another man's gold.
Another man's gold.
They got
absolutely
30 minutes of us fucking. Babbling.
Hey, guess who's got some dates now? Dan Soder. Hi. He's going to be at the Pittsburgh Improv. Ooh. Dude, I haven't been there in so long.
I've never been to Pittsburgh.
It's the one in Homestead. It's great. I like it a lot. It's cool. It's a very theater feeling inside of it.
Yeah.
But that was the club I told you I did years ago on Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
And they go, it's not going to be a big crowd. It's Thanksgiving weekend, and we have no press, and I had no audience. And it was small audience, but it was so fun.
Yeah.
And then when I tried to go back, they were like, yeah, you didn't draw anybody. He goes, you guys told me I wasn't going to draw.
Yeah.
Like, you said you weren't going to penalize me for that.
What the fuck?
But it is an awesome club. So,
yeah.
And that's Dan's going to be there June 3rd through the 5th. After that, he's going to be in Royersford, PA, Red Bank, New Jersey, Dallas, and Sacramento. Ooh, Daniel is traveling on a plane.
He's going on a sexy city tour.
For tickets and all their tour dates, go to dansoder.com because we all know...
Well, guess what? The Worst is back in New York City because New York comedy clubs are officially open. The Worst, hosted by Big J. Okerson, is coming back to the Stand this Wednesday. That's 2 days from today. April 7th at 8 p.m. Jessica Kirsten, Derek Gaines, and Shane Gillis. That's an awesome fucking lineup. Go to thestandnyc.com for tickets.
Christine, isn't that just Dan fucking kicking people in the balls? Isn't it sold out? No, cannot hear you.
Also, why would you put it up?
Equipment.
Why would you put it up in the plugs if it's sold out?
I don't think it's completely sold out.
Okay, so go down.
Oh, good. Well, I need two tickets put aside. I told you because I met people outside who were fans live across the street. So I had the big dick.
You gotta,
why don't you guys come to the show? Get some tickets.
You got to grease the wheels a little bit.
Yeah, I think she said she was in one of the Preston and Steve. Said she met me at one of the calendar things. They have their bikini calendar, so I don't know if she was one of the girls or not.
Oh.
Tell you what, I can give Christine her name off thing, and we could take a peek to do.
Do it. Text it. And we won't say her name. We'll just look at the picture.
No, of course. I'll text it to Christine.
Big J is coming to Kansas City this weekend, April 9th and 10th. That's Friday and Saturday. And then he's going to be in St. Louis, Columbus, Ohio, Providence, Rhode Island. For tickets and other tour dates, visit BigJComedy.com. We're both hitting the road. Jay is fully vaxxed.
I'm fully vaxxed.
I got the antibodies, but I'm looking for that sweet-ass vaccine. Jacob, did you get it?
I got the first shot. And then how'd you feel? The second one. It's just fine. Little tired the next day, but that was it.
Christine says we have a delivery from Lasership.
That's pretty
badass. What do you think that is?
Witzke, did you get yours?
I got one down, second one on Thursday.
Damn, dude. What about you, Brendan? Did you get a shot yet?
Nah, dude, I'm naked.
Me too, man. Me and you were naked. I got the antibodies, but that time's running up.
Okay, here.
I got to fucking go get the shots. Maybe I'll try to find... I'm going to try to go outside of Walgreens and ask if they got that Johnson & Johnson on a Friday. Get that one-shot dose, you know?
Yeah?
Get stuck with it and just fucking go.
Yeah, it's fine if you want to have the weird one that no one likes.
Shut up, dude. But it's the affordable one. You can't all wear JNCOs, Jay. Sometimes we have to wear utility jeans from Target.
That's true.
It's a life lesson.
I gave it to Christine.
Oh, this is the girl that you met outside that you gave tickets to?
Well, her and her boyfriend.
How quick did she drop boyfriend?
I met them both. They're both outside. No, I'm not that guy, but, you know, I want to. They were outside. They live across the street in a building, and they recognized me, so I wanted to be like, oh, yeah.
Did they run across the street, or were you on the same side of the street?
Same side of the street they were on, but they got out of their car for it.
Whoa.
So, pretty big deal.
I'm going to ask you objectively, was she hot?
I think she was. But, like.
Tell me, I don't know if this is.
I might not either. Nothing's coming up for that?
Is there?
A Christ Almighty, no. No.
Gadzooks.
No.
Who's the lady with the healthy chest third row down?
No, it's horrible. Daniel.
I fuck fives and sixes.
Whoa, Christine, these are people.
Let me look on my IG. Maybe she's on my IG. I don't know these things.
I mean, honestly, dude, that's an Aurora 8.
Someone's MySpace profile pic.
And it's still, that would be very on brand if you were like,
let's see. Maybe.
Can I tap in for a second?
Of course,
yeah, sure.
Anytime,
Jacob.
What I'm packing like a mean hog.
Yeah, probably.
Oh, found it. Okay, how do I send this to you? Can I send a profile to you, Christine?
DM her the profile.
Copy profile URL or share this profile?
You got that bank screen on your phone, dude. No one can see what you're looking at.
You're
how
welcome.
How can you see at it?
I'm going to copy the URL. How about that?
Man, how did you get your phone like that? How did you tint your phone?
It's a thing. It's services.
Dude, I got to do that.
What's happening?
I always feel like everyone's watching my phone when I'm on a plane. Do you guys do that? Do you ever read at someone else's texts? Yeah. I mean, obviously. You do?
Whenever I can see somebody's, if I can see the phone next to me, I'm reading what's being typed.
Always. Can you read it quickly? Can you figure out what's going on like pretty fast?
Yeah, it's not even like, by the way, I'm not like sneaking over. I mean, like if I notice myself doing it, like if it's a friend I'm sitting next to and I look and I read, I'll look away. But if I'm sitting on next to a stranger, like the minute you look down, you can see it. Don't you stay on it and read it?
Man, I would love to catch someone sexting. You know, they're just like on the subway. And they're like, yeah, is that what you want to do?
My decision would get was as much as like, I was like, I need a screen protector on it. He goes, do you want the regular screen protector? He goes, or it's one of those where he just goes, for $3 more, they have the one where, like, no one can see, like, look over your shoulder at it. And I was like, sure.
You always want to show people stuff on your phone.
I know, which I said.
Where you can't do that.
People are like, I have no idea. People are like, I don't know what you're showing me at all. I go, what do you mean? He goes, totally black. I'm like, wow, this thing works. I'm
like, this thing is fucking effective.
Did you get the thing that Christina sent you?
Send it
to myself. Yeah, send it to yourself. It looks like, by the way, from the picture in the initial thing, I haven't looked at anything else. She does look pretty hot.
Mm-hmm. Well,
they had a nice car.
We judge by personality here.
But just because she's a bikini girl, I don't know if it necessarily means she's a stripper or anything. That wasn't just about strippers.
No, it was a bikini thing. Oh, heavens no.
That's how I know Eleanor...
Roosevelt.
Eleanor Roosevelt.
Former First Lady.
Don't read the handle.
Eleanor Kerrigan's niece was in one of these things, too.
Was this her?
I saw her there. This is the girl, yeah. No, Christine. I guess they're married. Mm-hmm. Get to some... You know what the hell we're looking for, Christine. So I'm showing us shots of their view.
Stop it. Oh, stop it, Christine. Grow up.
I'll go.
Grow up.
Get... Oh, you don't want to see her beautiful kitten?
Cat people are weird.
Good radio.
I'm kidding. Cats are cool. Cats are cool. I'm all right with cats.
There's one. That's all right.
Yeah. No, she's hot, for sure.
Yeah.
But she really is not. I mean, I thought it was going to be more showing it stuff, but like...
She's a married woman now.
Oh, yeah. Go way back to when she wasn't married.
I do want to be this girl's friend. She lives in her building?
No, she lives across the street.
Are you going to single white female her with friendship, Christine?
I'd like to.
Well, she's coming to the show on Wednesday. So there you
Damn.
Go. She's the one in the back.
Oh, okay. Who's the lady in the front?
I don't know. She's got a lot of face.
Excuse me, miss. Hi, I saw a picture from about 3 years ago. It was one of your friends. that's how you meet her.
Hey.
Real quick, about six rows down, all the way to the left.
All right. This girl takes pictures. This girl, I got to say why I think I already like this girl, is she is not obsessed with taking pictures of herself.
Man, you ever
she
seen someone's
Piff?
Look, I'll get past that. What are you going to do? When was he in New York City? Christ only know. She's been to the bitter end. All right, let's not stalk her, Christine.
Yeah. Christine,
Well, that was for Piff.
Shout out,
Coheed and Cambria.
You could tell... What's that one?
No. Is it?
No.
No, it's a friend of hers.
Yeah. Dude, well, her friend rules.
She likes Alan Rickman.
Who doesn't like Alan Rickman?
What are those tickets for, Christine? Hang on. She likes Bad Religion.
She
Giants
likes
versus Eagles.
Now,
she an Eagle? Is she an Eagles fan?
With Preston and Steve.
Yeah, dude. She might be a Philadelphia girl.
Yeah, she's a Birds fan. Yeah, you know what? This chick's all right. Maybe she's going to be our newest friend.
Dude, that's how you should, after the show, when you talk to her, you go, hey, we looked at your Instagram, and you're pretty cool.
You know what? I'm emailing her back. I'm emailing her back. Tell me what to say, Dan. Make me look cool.
I go, what's up, slut? It's your boy.
What's up, slut?
BJO.
It's your boy. Capital B, capital J, capital O.
Wondering who you think the Birds are taking in the draft.
Who do you think?
Embiid's a stud, right?
Birds. Hang on, Dan. I don't type that fast.
Hold on, bro. I'm just going with it.
I'll tell you what. They really go to see the hackiest comedy shows. So it's Caroline to see Kevin Smith, Gotham for Piff the Magic Dragon.
Yiff.
Like, do you like anybody who just tells jokes? I mean, come on.
Hello. Sorry, everyone. Welcome to the first annual Random Bonfire Roast. Got a great dais. The lady from across the street is here.
The lady from across the street, Christine. Yeah, become friends with her.
Dude, get in there. Burrow, Christine. Burrow into this woman's life. And then change it.
Look. Fine. There it is. Look.
Preston and Steve.
Finally. Yeah, dude, she's smoking hot.
Wow.
2015.
Okay, I was going to say the year because then they can just look it up.
Yeah. Oh, so he went back. All right, he went back to tape. Yeah, dude, she's smoking hot.
Good job, lady.
Good job, lady. We're just going to call you lady.
Hey, ladies.
Well, keep going now, Christine. Now we're getting back to the hoary days.
Yeah, this is...
This is the good stuff?
This is her rudderless, just puttering around Philadelphia.
Time she sucked off
now here comes the selfie.
She sucked off a security guard so she can meet fucking Penn Jillette.
Yeah. She goes, imagine dragons came through town.
And you know what I did?
Oh, that's, I think, the beginning of the relationship. Oh, guys.
Yeah. Beginning of the end, dude.
Whoa, bro.
That guy marrying her seems like he never pictured his life could be so good.
I don't know if that's necessarily him. It might even be a bad picture. The guy, I mean, who I assume is her husband that she was with the other day, who I assume she'll be bringing that night, was a handsome dude for sure.
What if he's a fan of the show and he's just listening to this right now at his office and he's like, hey, honey.
Hon?
Remember when you used to whore around Philly? They're talking about that moment. And I asked you to take some of those pictures down.
It seems like a cheerleader went with like a tech guy, you know? It just seems like he's a little, it's the move. Like she's a hot girl and he's nerdy a little
That's
bit.
That's the move, ladies. But you get the hunk when you're young and the dork when you're old.
But she's not just
fucking
a,
live in a nice house.
Okay, the guy she was wasn't a dork. Maybe I'm wrong, but he didn't seem dork to me.
Because then
at all.
Dorks get money and then dorks hire personal trainers.
But she
might not be a dork anymore. It's like 6 years later.
Maybe. But she whatchamacallit, but she definitely, like I said, she's a girl. Like I said, she's a hot chick, but she's not all about just pictures of herself. Even back then, it's not a ton.
I'm telling you.
That's like the only salacious thing she brings. Christine, you want to be friends with her? Now I feel like you don't. That's fine.
Wow. Christine.
You got intimidated by her looks, and look at you. Now you're
gossipy
out.
Gossipy bitch.
Yeah,
I thought that was a classy Instagram page.
I thought so too, Jacob. It was classy.
The ones I see, the girls I follow, they all have three things in common. They all post hot pictures.
Yeah.
Dog photos and messages about social injustice.
Yeah.
Letting you know, hot girls are all for equality.
Those girls comes to fucks. No, I say I'm very surprised.
But none of them have a boyfriend, by the way. They can never find a man.
I'm very surprised this young lady's thing is just really, it's not riddled with self pictures at all. It's Eagles tickets, fucking concert pictures and stuff. It's great.
I would think this is a, I feel like this is a pedophile hunter posing as a hot girl.
Yeah. You think it's a pedophile hunter?
It's that Shane guy going like, hey, you guys want to hang out? And you're like, yeah, I was going to go to the Eagles game with this girl. And then it was just this weirdo smoking Newports.
Yeah, we got
to
do a Lost Tapes one day again soon where we catch up with all the individual solo pedophile hunters. There's a bunch more.
Go back into the indie circuit.
They haven't stopped. Just because we stopped covering hunting? Them, just because we stopped covering them doesn't mean they've stopped doing what they do.
Listen, the content's out there. You just got to go find it.
The content is out there.
Speaking of pedophile hunters, they should send them off after the people that paid for Bad Baby. Where does it? Oh. You had an interesting theory we were talking about it this weekend. You're like, it's gonna go to a place where she has to show. Get naked.
Or she's going to just, well, it's not gonna, she's going to have to. If she goes, I want to make a couple million dollars really quick, in over the next 2 months, 3 months, she could make probably over $10 million.
Jesus, at 18 years old?
Maybe.
Oh, man.
Maybe that, but maybe less. Let's say it's like $4 million, $3 million in the next 3 months, $1 million a month. That's pretty fucking fantastic. And not show anything. Except be like sort of sexy, but not naked stuff at all.
Couple kissy faces.
But then
faces.
People are going to start checking out. So if she wants that easy money to just keep rolling in, she's either
she
going.
She strings people along forever she's, and never gives them what they want.
No, but you just can't do. No, I'm saying it just won't happen. It won't work out for her. Like they'll eventually stop. It'll be very short lived. It'll be months, 3 months.
That's what Sierra Sky's doing, and I have to go and like cancel the membership.
Yeah.
Why she was stringing it along? Because she said it was her first boy-girl scene.
Yeah, but he slaps her ass.
That's it?
I don't know. Do a checkup, Christine. We have two OnlyFans subscriptions. Let's joke check them out again every day. We always check on Miss Poindexter and Sierra Sky.
A camper messaged me and said that Mrs. Poindexter makes $100,000 a month.
Really?
Yeah.
What do you think her mom makes?
Fucking
what do you think Grandma Poindexter makes?
50 in medical.
It's just I do it for the love, you know.
Well, I get my Medicaid, and then I, you know, can send $10 to all my grandkids when I'm not S&D over here on OnlyFans.
Go, take a picture, hon. I got batch on my tits from last night.
Put it in between my old lumpy pillows.
That's from Greg, the guy I meet at the bowling alley sometimes for sex.
You know, my Walter used to turn me upside down and really ring me out. These new guys don't know how to love a lady. Anyways, my daughter had got me into the OnlyFans game. Hey, Mrs. Poindexter. Mrs. P. Nelson the Bighorn Ram approves. Wait, hold on. Who's Nelson the Bighorn Ram? Nelson does not approve of my 7mm.
Oh, she. You know, she's moved on to, like, she's saying, like, she's getting fucked constantly by other people, like, with her goddamn kids.
Wait, what?
Yeah. She has a thing. I just got fucked by so-and-so. Go down. Go down these posts. We had this on the show already. Oh, maybe that was when DeRosa was on.
Yeah, it was.
Yeah. One of my hot wife dates was when you go out and fuck other people.
I got a hot wife date. Wait, is she hooking now?
I don't remember that.
It's not hooking.
Annabelle will be out later tonight. What else can I get into? Do you think it just gets...
She's going to fuck younger guys because spring break's over.
When you walk by the Good Mills house in your neighborhood, this is me inside. Okay.
She's like Whitney Cummings.
Just getting a little ready. It's got to be exhausting when someone's this sexed up, right? Where you're just like, I feel fucking tired. And she's like, yeah, because I was going to go by the store and see if I could suck off one of the stock boys.
Yeah. That would get tiring after a while. Just, can we never stop?
Can we just please fucking talk?
Nonstop.
Have you read anything recently?
Honey goes, he's like, honey, I'm gonna run the Starbucks real quick. Okay, he goes, want me to do it with a butt plug in? Like, sure.
She goes, you know, I went to the store to pick up that pound of pasta salad, and I kept thinking about the guy at the deli's cock under his pants. Dude, and you're like, all right.
There is. By the way, I like a sexed up chick.
I asked you to get fucking Post-its too.
Dude, yeah. I like a sexed up chick, but dude, there is definitely limit to that. Of it's like, yeah, he goes, so I went to the deli and the deli guys were cute, so I jacked them both off in the back, and then I got my Alpine lace and then I left. Isn't that hot? And you're like, sure, babe. Like, could we? I don't know. Just jump on the OnlyFans, see what we're doing money wise.
Have you seen my charger? No, but you know what's pretty crazy? The apartment down the hall was moving, and I thought, like, what if all five of those guys just gangbang me? And you're like, yeah, I'm not feeling good. I think I'm queasy from lunch.
She goes, I'm saying, do you mind if I go get plowed out by Phi Beta Kappa?
I don't know. I'm.
Do you care if I get fucked by the Omegas?
I just found out my grandma's friend died, and, like, I loved Barb. I don't care about you being sexed up.
No, I care, too, and the wake's on Sunday. I know I'm not doing anything on Sunday morning for this at all.
How mad would you be if I grabbed her hand and played with my pussy? And you're like, that's disgusting.
No, but just for, like, a second for the OnlyFans.
Yeah.
People love it.
What are you talking about? You want me to suck your cousin's dick? You're like, no. Yeah. We're at a family
Marjorie,
funeral.
I miss you every day.
Yeah.
With a blue hand just fucking just sliding up the envelope.
Oh, Christ. Yeah, dude, there has to be a limit. Because, like, I understand it. I completely understand, like, the sexed up, like, talking through your teeth kind of behavior.
Sure.
Like, yeah.
Like,
yeah.
But then, yeah, I'm actually not good at that.
I don't mind it. I don't mind that at all, but... I'm saying once you come, you have this, like, all right, so now I'm normal again. I'm not the wolf man.
Yeah, but I have a hard time breaking out. That's what I'm saying. Because I can't break out of it like that, I never get into it. Like, I never get into it. Fucking,
well, that's why dumb people...
I think you never get to a point where you're, like, guttural.
No. Of course I'm guttural. I'm fucking. I'm just saying, like, I don't have, like, a, yeah, you fucking, yeah.
Yeah, dude.
I'm just not that, I don't think that's my temperament at all, sexually.
But that, I'm saying, to live that kind of lifestyle, you need a lot, some people need that.
Yeah, for sure.
That's the appeal of it. Yeah. Of her being like,
you're gonna go suck off that guy at the grocery store? Yeah.
And then you go, hey, I just found out, like, quarter three, we lost like 25% of our earnings. She's like, yeah, what does that mean? And you go, it means we're not going to Barbados this year like we planned. She goes,
yet not even for this? Look how wet I am. So hard for me?
No, you go, yeah, I guess I am. Like a sad hard. where you're like,
then why don't you call your boss Derek over to fuck me and call me faggot and call you faggot while he does it? I don't know, babe. I'm not really into that today.
I kind of wanted to watch the Colts and the Bucks tonight on Monday Night Football. So.
Do you mind if he yells and calls you faggot from the room while he fucks me? He goes, I really just rather Dennis not come over tonight, babe. He's my boss. I want to watch the game. I want to have a few beers.
I think I'm just going to get a townhouse. I got to move out. This is weird.
Dude, the cuckold section of pornography now is inundated. Always a new thing. That was a lot of it was the stepmom stuff for a while, and now it's been taken over by the boss. This fake story is like you have to let your boss fuck your wife.
Weird corporate policy. Yeah. Just to let you guys know here.
Speaking of wait, where's Bambi on that one, huh, HR?
Yeah, right? That's $90 a month. You can work that into your policy.
$90 a month. You can make sure your boss doesn't fuck your wife right now.
There you go. So a little thing here at Gyrotech is that by month six, if you're still an employee, I come over and raw dog your wife in front of you.
Yeah. Hey, Jim McClure, if you're listening, you owe me one. I owe you one. You take a swipe at Christine one night.
Dude, that'd be so great when we come back in the office and he's just eating an apple on his doorway. He goes, just looking at what's mine.
Yeah, just McClure.
Like, I come in, I make that joke.
I come in, and Christine or McClure sitting on the edge of Christine's desk, laughing with her. I just see her laughing a lot. I go, the fuck is this about?
And her hands on his leg. And yeah. He goes, oh, hey, Jay.
He goes, oh, hey. And he overplays his hand with me. He goes, ah, there's my star talent, huh? Next Howard Stern, some people are saying. Goes, oh, man, anyway. He goes, you got a good gal here.
He points to me, he goes, Dan, and you're staying in Jersey? And I'm like, I'll break your fucking hand. I'll break your goddamn hand. I'll kill you, you son of a bitch.
McClure bangs Christine.
He goes, oh, hey, we're just going over some reads.
And I sit with my legs folded in the corner like this. When you're done having her, we'll discuss contracts.
Dude, what, do you think you can predict where the next wave of cuckold porn is going? Since it's moved from stepmom to boss, do you think it's like a... Do you think it's like ever going to be like the
blue? It's never when they go away. They just add things in. So it was also next door neighbor, they'd say a lot. Like next door.
And that's what's happening with Mrs. Poindexter for real.
By the way, there's still, for sure, there's still the... I tell you, I watch like the home video ones.
You watch like alien abduction videos of them.
Yes. Yes.
It's like shaky hands and you only see a little bit of it. And you're like, I think I saw something.
Yeah, no, for sure. So they just add on things. So now the bossing's add on the neighbors. What's the next? I don't know what the next.
Have they ever done a gambling one?
Delivery guy was big. Those are great.
The delivery guy
ones are great. Yeah. But sometimes
one time when I was delivering pizzas in high school, a lady answered the door in a towel out of the shower, and I was like, "Is this about to happen?" And then she's like, "Thanks," and she gave me the money to the door, and I was like, "Okay, back to the store."
I tried to get Christine to show her chaunch or butt to delivery guys so many times. I was like, "Make their whole year."
Yeah.
Just make their year.
What if they're like Muslim men that like can't deal with that?
They're like, why?
He just fucking stabs you a second you're done.
You are a fucking whore.
Box to the Sonny and Annie's delivery guys.
Yes, you can.
Can I show you Sierra Sky's private page? What she asked for tips really like bums me out. Actually, right, when I saw it.
Yeah. Why? Like, you had a lot of respect for her. She was your shit before?
Yeah, why? You liked her as an artist?
I didn't realize that she was your jam.
She is, but I thought. Christine, I mean, I guess not.
We are Team Roman.
She's on OnlyFans.
I know, but like, look, not this one. Who knows what she's saying? I don't know what I'm looking at.
It's her as a bunny. Look. Tip $15 to see us pull out each other's boobs and grab them. Really?
Wow.
Yo, that is sick. What? Oh, my God.
Do you think it's a bargain? I think it's ridiculous.
Grab whatever you want, baby girl.
I just think that she's
smackers.
Like,
that is $15
on flat titties. It's so trashy.
That is pretty trash.
Garbage.
Dude.
Is this because of COVID, though? Like,
she's
just not working as much?
What, do you think her mind's going wacky because she had COVID?
You think she got COVID cloud?
You think she has clouded thought?
She goes, I came out of that, and it turns out I did a lot of girl-on-girl stuff I'm not so proud of.
She goes, I did what with who?
She goes, I did a slap titty Friday night with Angela. Slapped each other's tits for $15 a week.
She goes, you guys, I did aggressive throat fucking. I did gagging porn for a little bit.
Which is weird, the thought of, is that what it is? Is it like $15 a slap, like a carnival thing? You go, you get three slaps, give me $15.
Tip 15 to see us pull out each other's boobs and grab them. A lot of people did it.
Yeah. Oh, my God. A lot of people did it. A car payment's worth.
$40.
We go down to Mrs. Poindexter. I want to hear.
By the way, that lady's charging more for her fucking AIDS-y crackhead pussy. Then Sierra's showing us the squeeze. And by the way, the other thing, she goes, look, I'm charging you $25 less than this lady's selling pussy for.
So just be cool. Oh, wow. Booty twerking and popping to start your Monday off right. Who do you think won?
I don't know, but I'll tell you what. Her friend is real garbage. I think that's the friend who talked her into doing OnlyFans.
She goes, listen. Razor said that we could make like fucking $9,000 a month.
That girl on the right, that girl on the right's pussy doesn't smell only 6 days a month.
Wow.
There's 6 days a month where it doesn't smell bad.
What does it normally smell like?
It's just spicy. Do you know what I mean? All that time, like that zip of like a real... Like
sulfur and gravel?
You know when you found out that your armpits smell? When you find out?
Yeah.
That smell.
Yuff.
When it hits you and you're like, oh, shit.
It's like
shit.
It's like football pad stink.
Yeah.
Got out at the right time.
Roman probably threw a cigarette and then it blew up.
Yeah, she's losing it.
Go back, go down.
Paying for a private account, and it also costs $19 to unlock posts.
Because she's smart?
Because that's how she gets you? That's how she gets you, Christine. I think you're so upset.
You're whipping by this, and I'm trying to see what Mrs. Poindexter is writing.
You want to Jill so hard Milfus to fucking to Sierra. What are you reading? You got to read out loud, Dan. It's a radio show.
I was trying to read it before I read it on air, but she wrote, how's this for Easter colors? And you're like, I'm with my family, Mrs. Poindexter. We're having a ham right now. What are you doing? He is risen. What are you doing?
Is that happening in the other room of Easter?
Yeah.
Like, she goes, you guys.
There it is. There is the egg. Good job, Colby. Those are the eggs. And she's in the bathroom, and she's like, I just got my pussy slapped around by Mr. fucking Ding-a-Ling.
How do you like these eggs? And this bunny down here.
Look at this bunny.
In the background, you just see a kid find an egg. Got one. He comes out.
I think she's starting to MILF Wu-Tang, because the way she's describing these women, where she's like, it's me and Annabelle and Ellie, the redheaded nanny, and probably Professor Betty.
Oh, my God.
Should be fun.
Are these wacky fake characters?
Dude, they're totally fake. I don't think she knows
Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood.
Dude, she's totally making up these women.
Oh, Professor Betty.
Yeah.
Why is your vagina out?
This has to be her husband writing this, right?
Yeah, he's in too.
He's got to be ghostwriting this. Where he's like,
they're gonna lose. They have three children. One of them's gonna commit suicide.
No, you think one of the kids will end it?
One, and then the other two will realize they have to be strong for Kevin.
Jesus Christ, we never forget him though. We have matching tattoos.
No, we never forget Kevin. We feel terrible about
my
Kevin.
Easter color theme for today. I'll post a video in a bit. How did your Easter go today, sweetheart? That's fucking gross. That's cool to a certain point.
I'll tell you what's bizarre about this. Also, and it does make sense to some degree. She got this body to do nothing with it. So now she is using it for something. That's why I think it's odd when girls really get like done up, like surgery-wise for their bodies. And it's like, to do what? Like to be married, not fuck other people, and like just be a mom and things? What's the point?
Just to let your kids think you're sexy.
Like, you could work out and get your body, like, looking good. You just, like, why get the porno dimensions?
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Why get the porno dimensions if you're not going to do it? So, I guess, do it, but then, like, you know, I don't know. It's weird.
Have a little couth. Well, that's what we were talking about originally with the bad baby thing. It's like, where do you go from here? You made the $1 million. So, if you just wanted to prove a point, put out a picture of you in a bathing suit, then shut it down.
She's going to start splitting lip.
No, I don't think I'll take an over-under bet that you see boob, no puss.
Then she got thousands of people for whatever, it'll end up being somewhere under $100.
Yeah.
They're not going to spend over $100 before they need by that $100 to be cashed in on something. She has to show something. Top of bush, something.
Top of bush is easy. I would say we'd see it by Labor Day.
There's a girl, that girl who's married or dating the kid from the Spam commercials.
Yeah.
Mason Reese and Sarah Russi.
Yeah, we went through them before on a previous episode.
Yeah, Sarah Russi,
she does a very smart thing on the Instagram and things where you can't show anything dirty.
Yeah.
She's grown her bush line to go above where she, like, she gets, like, small bikini bottoms. So you see top of bush. So it's actually, it catches the eye. I won't lie to you.
Think work smarter, not harder. You grow your pussy hair out. You go around the rules.
I don't know if she's gotten shut down for it, but you see her pussy hair every post now. That's like her thing it's become.
Yeah.
Really, I don't know if she's with that guy anymore.
How do you follow that where you go, so what was it like? And she goes, like a big chicken nugget.
You do want to walk in, though, and be like, I mean, how do you not walk up to that girl confident no matter who you are? I'm like, hey, I'll take a swipe. I'll date your pig ass. Just nag her because.
What's up, Carney? What are you doing this weekend?
Yeah. What's up, you fucking dummy? Yeah. Come sleep in my place tonight.
She goes, fuck you. Do you know how big that guy's dick was? And you're like, oh man.
He may have had a fucking. I bet he had a thickie, man.
Just a baby arm?
Just a, like a thick neck of a dick. Yeah, you know what I mean? Like veins on it. Like.
What if you found out she was
tactile? Tactile vein work all around it.
And she's broken up about him. Like she's like, can we not? I can't do this right now.
She'd get over him very, very quickly. But it's not.
What, when you reach for something on the top shelf?
It's not about that. But I wonder if he could just bring her down. If he was able to get somebody else that hot very quickly, maybe he just has the game to do it.
Man.
I mean, he'll.
You're weird looking, learn your game, and then you can just.
Dude, they said Vern Troyer used to fuck constantly. And by the way, because you've got. Well, you have to
watching a woman get gamed by Mimi has to be an experience where he goes, come here, bend down. What's up, bitch? What's your name?
But you gotta have the confidence that rides beyond. Like, you're gonna have to fake it till you make it for a while. Not on the confidence scooping them up.
Sure.
Okay, because you're scooping them up and you've already resigned yourself to, like, they're coming here for the novelty a bit. Like, maybe I can make them fall in love, but first things first, the sinking into the teeth is.
We got to admit that you're both here because you're a little weird.
It's like you're trying to see what's going on with Vern Troyer's wiener and what does it look like.
You're a curious cat.
And then he's got to learn because pulling that thing out, like the girl is all, they're all going to have a reaction. It's just kind of like, oh, okay. like when you pull out your little wacky person wiener, it's going to.
So that's what it looks like.
Yeah, exactly. Vern Troyer had a lot of girls suck his dick because they're like, I don't know, I want to see what it looks like. And they go, oh, I'll tell you, a thing that...
Someone that hasn't played the sax in a long time, they lick their lips weird, they're like...
One of my most soul-crushing moments in my life. Oh, my God,
Did you just think of it for the first time? Since?
No.
I just unlocked something, and
it's a story. It's a part of a story. I told this story on... This is not happening, but I left this part of the story because it was that girl.
It was the girl that you guys banged with Kurt?
Yes. And this girl, well, you know, she got around. She was a loose one, this girl. And she that's what it was. We were playing Truth or Dare first, and she dared me to pull my dick out or something like that. And I just wasn't in a position to pull it out just yet. It was small right now.
Yeah, you're high and tight.
Yeah, I wanted to come. Like, I wanted to get some dangle on it first before I pull it out.
Man, there is not a more anxiety-filled situation than your penis having to show.
I don't want to pull it right now. You just being like,
I got drug weenie right now. It's all tight in. It's just fucking up and in, and you're like, oh, shit. Yeah. Do you got a hot shower around here?
You got like a bowl of warm water I can dangle these fucking beans in.
You got a steamer or steam room? I could fucking toast
my
nuts.
But she said that, And I go, yeah, I don't want to. I go, and she, I think she even said why. She goes, I'm not pulling out. I go, well, hell, let it get a little harder first. I said that to her, right? And she goes, oh, come on. And she basically, whatever it was, she convinced me to pull it out like soft. And I was like, it was almost like a warm, like kind of like, come on, you don't have to get like that. Like,
this trickster bitch.
I pulled it. No, she wasn't lying, but she just went with the flow of everything. But I go, I go, yeah, all right, here. And I pull that. And she goes, oh, see, that's great. She goes, I could do something fun with that watch. And she fucking put my bag and dick in her mouth at the same time. And it was, she did it like, isn't that cool? I can do that to you. I'm like, it upsets me that you eyed my dick up and go, that's the size I can do that one thing I can do to small dicks.
She goes, huh? Look at that. I took all
you
your...
go, oh, that's part of the trick. That falls in the category of ones I could do this with.
I gulp your manhood in one fall swoop. How fun is that?
Without a doubt.
Look at that, huh? Your manhood fits in my mouth. Anyways, I got to get out of here.
Yeah, everything that makes you, you.
Jake, can I also tell you something? Because I've watched that this is not happening, and I know the story. That woman was in a very bad place. Yeah. She was very broken. So
she was.
Don't let that make you
feel
any insecurity about your genitalia.
Yeah, but she bullfrogged my cock, which didn't make me feel good.
Yeah, because she thought you were going to be impressed, like you were going to high-five her when
she goes, look what I can do.
Yeah, and you
she
go.
Goes, oh, but whatever it was, the wording of it was the same. Like, she didn't say my dick was small, but she goes, oh, see, that's what's great about this. Like, basically, without saying the words, like, what's great about your dick being this small when it's soft is that I can do this thing. That's really, and I'm like, you know what? Maybe if I grew more, I'm a grower, but if I grew more, maybe I'd be like able to laugh by that. Like, ah, isn't that funny when it's small that goes like that? But it doesn't grow enough that you show me your little dick tricks you can do with my soft dick. I'm like, bitch, if you try to get my nuts in your mouth with my dick when my dick is hard, one of us isn't walking out of here.
Yeah.
One of us is dying tonight.
They go,
no, and two people aren't walking around with that info.
Someone asks you, have you ever put your hands on a woman? And you're like, once.
South Jersey.
Once.
But South New Jersey.
She definitely worked up to it.
She wanted it. She
Look,
had to come.
She watch takes me it make too. Stuff disappear and you go, oh, isn't that
Gene Simmons?
Gene Simmons.
She takes it too.
She takes it too.
Also, AKA Sexed Up Grandpa.
Yeah, his son was at the stand Saturday.
Hanging with Joey Roses.
Hanging with Joey Roses.
The Sandwich King of Midtown.
Oh, yeah. It's mom Shannon Tweed. Fuck, that's a hot mom.
I mean, the best. I'd almost just shake his hand to touch her DNA.
Man, back in the day, she had the blondest, just light brown thatch. Oh, and she showed that long beaver trail.
Man.
So great.
It was what a time. What a time to jerk off to VHSs.
She was just fantastic.
Only sometimes a slightly ripple of static.
Well, yeah.
Sometimes when we cross, when the volume would go and then it would come back, we'd be like, oh, and then you'd be like, oh, I don't know where his body is. God damn it, Drake.
Wait, what
and then
was
they
that?
Start fucking eating puss by a steam machine.
What was that button on VHSs? What was that button of it? Tracking?
Yeah, tracking.
I was forgot about tracking. It was unnecessary. He goes, you want to fix the tracking? He goes, how do I fix the tracking? It's staticky.
Yeah.
Why is this button making it not? Can it always just be the not staticky one?
Can I just hold this button down?
It's like the button could go one direction to make it super staticky or the other direction to make it not staticky. Why is there an option for super staticky?
Did you buy cheap porn and then have it break in your VCR?
No.
That happened a lot to me.
Really?
Yeah, I'd buy like a lot of VHSs, like the $3 for $10. And I'd go through like the bins. This is when I was like 17.
For like movies?
Yeah, like VHS movies.
But like what kind of movie? Like tit movies, you're saying? You're trying to
porn.
Find like porn.
Yeah,
oh,
it was porn.
Oh, actual porn.
Yeah, actual porn.
3 for $10? That's a hell of a deal for
VHS. Oh, but there were like weird, like there would be like Kimberly Cups and Class A student. And it was like, you know, like cheap ones from like the 80s, early 90s.
I never had those go bad on me, but what I did have a lot of was when you could order, if you got a porn magazine, they had the thing like anything else where you like tape a penny like Columbia House to the thing and send it off.
That's your BMG.
And they would send you a videotape, but it was just, they'd say they send you a free porn tape, but all it was a series of or a compilation of trailers for porns.
Which they would show the hardcore action in, but it was only a trailer.
They'd show the hardcore action in, and I'll tell you
how
what.
How do you find those fucking actual movies?
No, I'll tell you what. When you're a kid, it's just how long of a journey I go on with porn sometimes, which I've really been trying to dial back on.
Yeah.
Jerking in general, I'd say, and also just like the consumption of, like, not even the consumption of porn. I don't think I look at too much porn. I think in that one sitting, I have to find, it's like just pick something and jerk off to it already.
Yeah.
Like that's the thing. It's a snack, not a full meal. Yeah, too many options is what I'm running around to. Oh, this. That's what I'm trying to dial back.
Sure.
But back then, a tape But if you recall, the tape would be like the heads on it were the size of fucking tires. And then there's only like fucking four rolls of tape. It was like such short tape. So they were like 10-minute videos of trailer commercials, but man, I would beat off. You knew the part of the trailer that you're trying to sync up with.
Absolutely. And I could probably bust in like 2 minutes of porn back then. It was like 8 busts.
Because you knew, you were like, well, yeah, I have to like, yeah. You're like, if I don't come by this trailer, by the way, it's the last trailer. We're going to have to start the video over.
It would take me a good year to work through half of Splat on My Rack, too. That was just a long goal. You know?
Am I right?
You just knew you had to get there. Should we take our...
We've all been there, am I right?
Yeah.
Yeah, we should take a break. I don't know how we're doing this. Do we ever take our double break?
No.
All right, so we'll do this, and then we'll be back for, I don't know, 5 minutes?
Yeah.
Lou's doing all straight. He could just... We don't need Jacob anymore. He could just talk as Jacob now.
Can I tap in for a second? I shoot a BB gun in the garage.
Badass.
Yeah, let's take our break, and we'll be right back. It's the Bonfire.
I want to make omelets with Jacques Pepin.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Okerson and Dan Soder.
I hope you like junior bacon cheeseburgers. Guess what's more satanic than a spicy chicken sandwich? A number four.
Nothing.
A number four from hell.
Welcome back to the Bonfire, everybody. Sirius XM 103. This is Faction Talk.
I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Okerson. This is the Bonfire.
We have such limited time now because of our wacky ramblings.
Our hijinks.
That before the show is even sort of over, we have to get to our What's Fresh segment brought to you by Wendy's Biggie Bag. Get a bacon double stack, 4-piece crispy or spicy nuggets, fries, and a drink, all for just $5.
Jay, I know I'm not supposed to say this, but I'm gonna. That sounds like a great deal.
Secure the bag. That's the motto, and I like it. Secure the bag, always. Always secure that bag. The spicy nuggets are back. Yeah. I always play it regular at Wendy's.
Regular nugs?
Yeah, always.
I like spicy nugs.
We all know. It's not only is it my Mount Rushmore, it might be the Washington on my Mount Rushmore. Wendy's.
The nuggets.
No, just all around fast
food. Oh, yeah. We've thought. I mean, that is.
It's top
tier.
I enjoy it.
It's top tier.
Their cheese to beef ratio is on point.
It's showing up every year. It's getting it done. It's going to the playoffs. It's making you happy.
Although, do they still, are the classics still on the, like, Kaiser roll? Remember that was their thing?
Yeah, that was real good.
They're not anymore, though, right?
No. My mom hated square hamburgers. So for me, Wendy's was a little rock and roll.
that was your rebelling?
So for me, it really kind of broke the mold when I'd get a double cheeseburger and bring it home. Like, you know what? I'm going to have a square hamburger.
Square burgers were your Sergeant Peppers, dude.
Yeah, really broke out of my shell. Our What's Fresh segment today is we just found out there's a fresh clip of Marilyn Manson facing his allegations.
He did a press conference, actually. I used to really be up on Manson news. For the fact that Lou had to bring this to me upsets me.
Witzke, can I ask you, was it like a classic press conference, like an MLB or a post-NBA game? Like, was there like logos behind it?
Like, yes, you know, cameras flashing, yes.
Manson absinthe.
Before we dig into it too hard, I want to ask Brendan a question. Brendan, are you falling in love with this show in a way that when Black Lou comes out and tosses you aside like straight white male garbage, are you going to be upset because you've come to fall in love with the show and the humor we have?
No, I've always been a fan, though. I've been a fan since like Dovo Rules and stuff like that, so I'm going to keep listening.
Oh, hell yeah.
You're pretty. You know what, Brendan? You're cool in our book.
You're cool. if we ever have enough space for another straight white male permanently in this group, buddy, you're it.
I mean, we are chock full.
But I'll be honest with you.
Don't tell Andy they said that.
Yeah. Fury, you have to kill Fury or Jacob.
One of you has to become bi.
Oh, man. If one of you guys starts banging, then we can bring both of you on. So.
Yeah. Oh, I tell you, we could have you on a lot if you like. Would you mind having sex with Christine while I watch?
Now, here's the thing.
Brendan from work getting down on Christine's sniz.
She goes, hey, I know we're supposed to do reads, but I'm just so horny for that stock boy.
Christine's oversex Christine. Right. She goes, Brendan, keep your camera high. I'm going to suck you off under the camera.
So our What's Fresh, the press conference, Lou, did you watch it? Did you watch the press conference?
I did. It was very quick.
Let's see. Is it brought to you by Wendy's?
Is it Dunkin' Donuts in the back?
This is Get Fresh, dude.
Oh, yeah. It's Wendy's behind Marilyn Manson.
What's Fresh?
You know what I love is rising from my crypt to eat.
I'm going to get an Asiago ranch chicken sandwich. Do you want one, Dad?
Dad, are you a fan of dunking your fries in your Frosty?
Did you know spicy nuggets are back, Pop?
All right, well, I'm going to go. Thanks.
They stopped making the loaded baked potato, but actually, they have a multitude of salads now.
I just thought you could hit the drive-through with the Manson a lot where you go, I'm going to have number four. And how about a spicy chicken sandwich? Just regular sandwich?
You guys want to make chicken fries?
Sir, we don't. Well, let's hear the press conference.
Yeah, so he, you know, to catch everybody up, there was the allegations against him made by several women now, I think.
But one of them was the robot lady from Westworld. So
except,
I don't know if you can trust a cyborg.
Yeah, I mean, I thought they're supposed to not feel human emotions.
Also, check the Westworld programming, because I'm pretty sure you can F and toss them whatever you want.
Yeah, who's the Leisure Suit Larry who made that program?
Yeah. No, it was serious allegations by several women.
Several, right?
That Marilyn Manson was abusive.
Except Rose McGowan, the most victim-y victim of all time. And she still goes. She goes, I guess it was a piece of shit. Guess I just walked through the raindrops on that one somehow.
She goes,
The guy who dresses like
Guess Satan. You ladies like your rough play a little light.
What do you think she called him? She's like, Bri. What did you do to these girls?
What are you doing?
He goes, just the same thing I always did. You know, I'd brand them a little bit.
I tormented them with evil and sin. And she goes, I took them
on a twisted, wild ride through insanity.
I brought them to the limitations of their pain and understanding. She goes, spanking and hair pulling. I'm there for it.
I taught them to play with madness.
I chewed on their soul. neck biting. Got it.
Yeah, right. Just, you know, the hits. You're saying the old hits. Okay.
Was it contacts in or contacts out? Because that's a different whole experience.
Did you do the blood thing where you make yourself bleed a little bit and say that's how she's inside of you?
So they didn't like your boom boom room in the basement?
What's wrong? Nobody wanted to drink the vampire blood.
Oh, you mean Dante's Inferno? She goes, yeah, whatever, your man cave, whatever you call
it. He's got a bunch of girls absinthe out walking around the house.
This Jägermeister is making me see stuff.
That's not Jägermeister.
That's
the head vampire's blood.
What you're drinking is actually the marrow of an ogre. From a different time.
It's $14,000 a shot.
It's when the large people roamed the earth.
Go ahead, play this thing. Play this song, bitch.
Mr. Manson, is it true that you're a rape woman?
Oh, it's just audio?
Yeah.
Marilyn.
So that was it. He's walked in autumn.
That was it.
I got caught.
Wait, Lou. When did you get fresh the new Biggie bag? It's got a bacon cheeseburger, I think. I don't know. We thought you actually had a real press conference thing where he's answered. I didn't know you made a bit. And Dan sold it and made a whole big segment around it.
We're like, oh, man, there ain't nothing here. You just fucking
I'm like, it's just audio. It's so weird. Me and Dan both, by the way, sat here. It was 30 seconds long, you said, Lou?
Yeah.
7 seconds in, I felt like an ass. And by the way, kudos to you. 20 seconds in, Dan started to know what was happening. And then 26 seconds, realized that, we've been had.
I completely got Geraldo Rivera'd.
I told you it was a bit at another time. I just didn't tell you it was a bit today.
Lou, we smoke a joint per episode.
Do
you think we're going to remember that?
Yeah, that was crazy.
I didn't know you were going to sell it so hard.
I mean, we completely sold
out. We made it the bit. You could have said something on the commercial break when we said, what are we doing for Wendy's Get Fresh? Where now you can get a bacon cheeseburger and crispy or spicy nuggets
and unlike
fries and a drink right now for $5.
And unlike Lou, there'll be something in the bag when you go to Wendy's.
It was 20 seconds of footsteps.
Yeah, he gave us 40s radio effects.
And then the thunder came.
Clip clop, clip clop. That's actually my hands in shoes on a desk next to the microphone.
Yep, so he addressed the charges. That was it.
Let me get my rain stick. Hang on, my rain stick's in the other room.
Oh. Well, there you go, Wendy's. I hope you're happy with what you paid
for. That's the Wendy's What's Fresh segment, brought to you by Wendy's Biggie Bag. Get a bacon double stack, 4-piece crispy or spicy nuggets, fries, and a drink, all for just $5. Secure the bag and double-check your stories before you use them as segments.
Can we do the Menendez thing, or should we wait for
Not
tomorrow?
A chance, dude. No. Yeah. Not a chance.
3 minutes.
Oh, that's it?
Yeah.
Dude, hold on.
No.
No. I'm sorry. I'm wrong. Wind.
Six.
Is it doing it? Is it humming, coming at you?
You guys have scary wind. That's how high up you live. It's like,
Christine, you got to come plug the door.
Oh, hang on.
The whirring's happening again. The whistling. Christine, I can't hear you through the wind.
No, Christine. It's like the scene in Superman where Kevin Costner dies. Go into the building. I got this.
Man of Steel.
Wait, you said you wanted to do another movie thing.
Oh, yeah. This will take us right to the edge. Jacob.
Ooh, yeah, we're going to edge.
Jacob, question for you, buddy, because you're the only person who may have had a chance of seeing this also. You see the Footloose remake?
Zac Efron?
No, it wasn't Zac Efron. It was some other dude.
That was a few years ago, right?
It was a few years ago. It was on cable the other day, and I clicked it because I thought it was Footloose, and it was that. And I saw 10 minutes of it, and they made me
so angry this 10 minutes.
Christine, can you please bring up the trailer for the most recent Footloose?
It didn't have to be remade. And they updated it in the stupidest ways and left it the same in the stupidest ways. They have the kid dress exactly in the outfits Kevin Bacon wore and drive his exact car in 4 years ago world. It's taking place in modern times because when he drove up listening to Metal Health in the original, our old theme song, and he drove. Remember that when he drives up listening to Metal Health and the Beatle? Now it's Wiz Khalifa's Black and Yellow. No exaggeration. The Preacher, I forget what
it is. Let's see the trailer real quick.
But
I want to see.
I would say my biggest anger thing was the soundtrack is remade songs of a thing. So that's a modern version of I Need a Hero playing in the background of a scene. Chuck, the girl's boyfriend, is a NASCAR driver.
It's not Chris Penn. He's dead.
No, wrong guy. Oh, okay. That's his buddy.
Oh, yeah.
No, the guy that beat up Lori Singer. Julianna Hough looks like a fucking rich bitch princess, and that's not what the roll calls for. It needs Lori Singer to look like fucking garbage trash. Just like a rotating door of cock for a school because she's all bony and fucking preacher daddy. Julianna Hough was not the right kid. It was all bad.
Well, Christine, do you have the trailer up?
Yep.
Play it.
I want to see who stars in this because I kind of remember it being made, but I don't.
It was like Point Break didn't need to be remade.
That was a useless remake.
My uncle loved it.
Your uncle's an idiot.
Yeah,
he's a surfer. Uncle, he loved it.
He has head injuries.
Oh, he's got head injuries.
He probably hit coral.
Might have had injuries.
Tell him to wax his board.
Yeah, he goes, bro, it was Narnar.
It's wax.
All right, so they're doing all car accident. Oh, this is what stops dancing.
That's what stops dancing. Not because they were drunk.
Oh, Dennis Quaid is the Lithgow?
How dare he? Andy McDowell's the mom. Will be in
violation of the law. No dancing unless a new boy comes to town. MTV Films, they redid this.
Good. Now we know who to blame.
I appreciate you taking me in. I really want to pull my own weight around here.
If you can get this baby running.
I've never seen this guy.
When I was a kid, I actually believed people would have like secret dance parties. Like,
really?
I wasn't cool. I didn't understand like.
Because Dirty Dancing.
I never went to parties, so I thought this must be what it is. They're all dancing everywhere.
Nope, not at all, Jacob. What's happening here? Did you like the original Footloose, Jacob?
Yeah, I liked it. I don't think I was like a big. It wasn't as big to me as it was to you. For sure.
You weren't a Lucy.
But I always enjoyed the movie.
It's great, Footloose.
Jay wants to dance. I don't know why you don't realize.
Jay wants to.
Jay's got dance in his heart.
Shut your mouth. You'll see me dance when I need to dance.
Yeah, Christine. Apparently, you haven't seen when he's angry at you. He finds an empty warehouse.
There's going to come a moment. There's going to come a moment. I don't know if they even do a warehouse dance in this one, which is.
They have to. They have to do an angry fight dance in this. They had to have.
It's gonna pale.
Well, here, let's see. I mean, of course it will. We got three more minutes.
Like, I guess cool people dance.
They do.
No, look at her. She's like, you're hot.
This is the scene I saw.
Everybody's cute.
Hey, watch where you're going, little guy.
Sorry, man. Didn't see you.
Where are you from?
Oh, God. Miles Teller. Miles Teller plays
He's the Chris Penn. Yeah.
God damn it.
Church is cool. You think I'm
small town? So that's what Juliana Hugh was from.
All that attitude?
James Huff. You want to say Huff.
Oh, dance parties.
It's like a step up. He meets Footloose.
I didn't even get to this part, and I really, honest to God, what town are black and white people partying together with musically?
Yeah.
Torrance, California.
Christine, mute Christine. Put her thing down, Lou.
Put her down, Lou. Put the whole goddamn thing down.
Pot her down.
Then
we lose Footloose.
I'm okay with that also.
I will talk it through. I will talk through this visual on an audio medium.
Oh, I'm a dancer.
I thought you got that. She's yelling. You can just hear
Christine,
her.
You're potted down.
You can hear her yelling in the other room.
We hear you in here.
Just hear her bleeding through the wall going, I was at dancing parties.
Don't get mad at Lou. Technically, we're Lou's boss technically. So if we say pot him down, we got a pot he has to do what we say on the show.
Also, okay. She took away the trailer. Christine, well played.
I thought you couldn't hear it.
We don't need to hear it. Jacob, yes, your thoughts? We have 1 minute of show left.
Yeah. Well, make sure you go get tickets for the last tickets for the worst this Wednesday, April 7th at the Stand. You can go to bigjcomedy.com for tickets. Also to Kansas City this weekend.
St. Louis after that. Yeah.
St. Louis, Columbus, and also Providence, Rhode Island.
Dan's got Pittsburgh coming up June 3rd to the 5th. Royersford, PA, Red Bank, New Jersey, Dallas, Sacramento. DanSoder.com for all those dates.
Ta-ta for now.
Till later.
TTFN. So good.
TTFN.